Gurgaon was a sleepy little cluster of villages about 25 years ago, when the first real estate developers moved in, and a plan was chalked out in the 80s to kind of develop this into a satellite city of Delhi. So for the last 20 years that I've been seeing Gurgaon, it is urbanized primarily because of the private real estate developers. So there's a lot of kind of unplanned urbanization, as a result of which that the villages that existed at that time, it is their fields and their lands that were bought up to develop Gurgaon into this urban city. And what has happened is, because it was not in the interest of the developers to even focus on what's happening in the villages itself, that while Gurgaon has grown to be worldwide, a hub for the IT industry and the BPO industry and headquarters for MNCs, and it draws people, workforce from all over the world, especially auto sector, the villages have kind of sunk into a morass of where there's no development, there's no sanitation, the schools are pathetic. So none of the advantages of urbanization have reached those villages, and all the benefits of being in a predominantly rural society have gone. So they're kind of left nowhere. And we're kind of addressing that population from that aspect, where we feel that they're marginalized by the process of urbanization, as well as the migrant workers, the lakhs of migrant workers that have come to Gurgaon because of this urbanization. Mobile access differs from area to area. We're doing a project where we use 3G services, and it was really a kind of pilot to try out and see, can we use 3G broadcast to get into the primary school system in Gurgaon? And the 3G network is awful, to say the least. And it's so sad, because you kind of have the potential of reaching into these communities where FM signal is really, really bad because the tall buildings block off the signals. In Gurgaon, you have buildings which are as high as 24, 25 floors, and you have the villages are always low floor. At the most, there'll be maybe a three-story building. The schools are always single-story buildings. So they're really buried in a wall of concrete. So to get a signal to them is almost impossible. The cost, because a phone costs about 7,500 rupees. The basic package that we were able to identify was costing us some 400-500 rupees. Otherwise, for enough data to listen to enough programming every day, we are looking at about 700 rupees a month. That's way too high. I mean, that's just not acceptable. If you look at the basic mobile, then what happens is that in a family unit, we find typically the mobile is with the father or the husband, the man of the house. So while he's in the house, the family can listen to radio, community radio, can participate. But the minute he steps out to work or to go to the market or wherever, the mobile phone has gone with him. And that's the end of accessing, providing access to the women and to the children in the house, or even to the elderly, So for us, that is a major issue, that how do we get women listeners to call in, because in the daytime they don't have the phone with them. It's easy in terms of it's there. Yes, they can go and get a BSNL internet line or an Airtel internet line or whatever in the villages, because see, the villages are also now semi-urban. The villages have paying guests who work in the IT industry. So, it's like a kind of a hodgepodge of communities living together. But they can't afford it very often. Or there are layers in the villages who can afford it. So, you'll have those who had land and who sold it off, who maybe became shopkeepers or property brokers, or who started some businesses of their own. They are using the internet. They're using the internet to further their business. They're going to property websites to kind of find out available properties. So, they kind of, and the younger generation is on the internet, But the thing is that that's a very slim layer that has the money to access the internet, because it requires a computer. Even that itself is a cost. So then you have the rest not accessing the internet at all. So they're coming up with their own offline ways of accessing content, For example, going to entrepreneur and telling him that, okay, here's so much money, please put 100 songs into my phone in my language. So I want Bhojpuri songs. There are people who are saying, going to an entrepreneur and saying, can you put in 3 movies in my dialect, in my phone? And he's got this cheap Chinese phone with a little screen and he's sitting and watching a movie on that, you know. So they are coming up with these innovative things, but the fact is that there's a charge for it and you can't broadcast it. You cannot get that content out to the entire community. As a radio station, piecemeal, and because of other projects, we have been using existing technologies. We have been using mobile telephony for our community to reach us and for us to reach our community, because we do live phone-ins. We have been using the internet to research for programs. We do streaming. Our broadcast is available for anybody to listen anywhere in the world, you know, on streaming. But our focus is, I'm not really it's not that important for me that somebody sitting in Melbourne is able to hear Gurgaon ki awaaz, though it can have a value of its own, but it's not the most important thing for me. But I want to know that can 70 children sitting in a village school in Gurgaon access that broadcast through the internet? Can they access, like if they're listening to an audio content, say on math and literacy, can they also have access to the internet to be able to do interactive sessions on the same topic? Can they do that as well? Can they have access to a phone line where they can call in with their queries, or where they can phone in and listen to another story for the day?